Ballistic. This is the type of missile most people think of when they hear the word. A ballistic missile is powered by a rocket engine for only a short portion of its flight. It is launched on a high, arcing trajectory, traveling up through the atmosphere and into space, before coasting and falling back down toward its target, much like a thrown ball. They are incredibly difficult to intercept because of their immense speed on re-entry. A modern subtype is the anti-ship ballistic missile. It is built to hit moving warships, using guidance updates in flight and a terminal seeker during re-entry. Submarine-launched ballistic. The SLBM is the most survivable component of a nation's nuclear triad. These are large, multi-stage ballistic missiles, nearly identical in function to land-based ICBMs, but launched from the missile tubes of a submerged ballistic missile submarine. Their power comes from stealth. Because the submarine's location is unknown, the missiles are effectively immune to a preemptive strike, guaranteeing a devastating retaliatory capability. American Trident D-5 and Chinese JL-3 are prime examples. Cruise. Unlike a ballistic missile that goes into space, a cruise missile is a self-guided weapon that flies its entire journey within the atmosphere, like a small pilotless jet aircraft. It is powered by a jet engine and uses wings to generate lift. Its key advantage is the ability to fly at very low altitude, hugging the terrain to hide from enemy radar. Modern cruise missiles, like the American Tomahawk, are incredibly precise, using GPS and onboard cameras to strike a target the size of a single window from over 1,000 miles away. ALCM means air-launched. SLCM means submarine-launched. GLCM means ground-launched. Hypersonic. This is the newest and most feared category. A hypersonic missile travels at speeds of Mach 5 or higher. There are two main types. A hypersonic glide vehicle is launched on a rocket like a ballistic missile, then detaches and glides toward its target on a maneuverable and less predictable path. A hypersonic cruise missile uses an advanced scramjet engine to fly at hypersonic speeds within the atmosphere. Their extreme speed and agility make interception extremely difficult. Hypersonic describes a speed and flight regime and can sit on top of ballistic boosters or within cruise designs. Surface to air. A SAM is launched from the ground or from a ship to destroy an enemy aircraft or an incoming missile. These are the backbone of modern air defense. They range from shoulder-fired manned portable systems like Stinger to medium-range systems like Patriot to long-range strategic systems like S-400 that can engage targets hundreds of kilometers away. Air-to-air. These are missiles launched from one aircraft to destroy another. They are the primary weapon in modern aerial combat. Short-range heat seekers like Sidewinder are designed for dogfights and home in on engine heat. Long-range radar-guided missiles like AMRAAM are used for beyond-visual-range combat, where a pilot can fire at an enemy seen on radar but not with the naked eye. Air-to-surface. This broad category covers missiles launched from aircraft to strike targets on land or at sea. They allow an air force to destroy targets from standoff distances, outside the reach of many defenses. This ranges from large long-range air-launched cruise missiles fired by bombers to smaller precision-guided weapons designed to crater runways, collapse bunkers, or break armored columns. Surface to surface. This is a general term for missiles launched from the ground or from ships to strike targets on land. While it includes large intercontinental systems, in conventional warfare, it often refers to tactical battlefield weapons. Examples range from guided multiple launch rocket systems that can saturate an area with precision munitions to powerful tactical ballistic missiles like ATACMS or Iskander that can destroy high-value targets deep behind enemy lines with a single large warhead. Anti-ship. These specialized missiles are designed to destroy enemy warships. Modern examples are notoriously difficult to defend against because many are sea-skimming, flying just a few meters above the surface to remain below the radar horizon until the last moment. They can be launched from aircraft, ships, submarines, or coastal batteries. Exocet and Neptune are well-known examples. Anti-tank guided. These missiles have one purpose: destroy heavily armored tanks. Modern systems like Javelin are highly sophisticated. Many use a top attack flight profile, climbing and then plunging down to strike the thin top armor of a tank. Many are also fire and forget, allowing the operator to take cover immediately, while the missile guides itself using an onboard seeker. Anti-radiation. These highly specialized weapons hunt and destroy enemy air defense radars. An anti-radiation missile carries a passive seeker that listens for and homes in on the electronic emissions of a radar. It is the primary tool for suppression of enemy air defenses, where pilots bait the enemy into turning on a radar, then fire to destroy the site and clear a path for other aircraft. Anti-submarine. These weapons are essentially rocket-delivered torpedoes designed to attack submarines from long distance. A typical system such as ASROC is launched from a ship or an aircraft and flies a ballistic or cruise profile to the target area. It then deploys a parachute and drops a lightweight homing torpedo into the water, which activates its own sonar to search for and destroy the submarine. Anti-ballistic. These are defensive missiles designed to do one of the hardest jobs imaginable. Hit a bullet with another bullet. Interceptors are the shooters in a missile defense system. They are built to destroy incoming ballistic missiles during flight. Some are exoatmospheric and strike the warhead in space, such as SM-3. Others are endoatmospheric and engage during re-entry at extreme speed, such as THAAD and Patriot PAC-3. Anti-satellite. These weapons are designed to destroy or disable satellites in orbit. They are a critical tool in space warfare since blinding GPS, communications, or reconnaissance can cripple a modern military. The most common type is a direct ascent anti-satellite missile, a multi-stage weapon launched from the ground, or an aircraft that flies into space to collide with the target. The United States, Russia, China, and India have all demonstrated this capability. Loitering munitions. Often called kamikaze drones, loitering munitions blur the line between a drone and a missile. Instead of flying directly to a preset target, they can loiter over the battlefield for an extended period under the control of an operator. This allows the operator to search for a target of opportunity and then command a terminal dive to destroy it. Switchblade and Lancet are well-known examples. Decoy. This is a unique category of missile whose purpose is not to destroy a target, but to deceive it. A decoy missile, like the American ADM-160M-ALD, is a small, jet-powered cruise missile designed to mimic the radar signature and flight profile of a much larger aircraft, such as a fighter jet or bomber. They are launched ahead of a strike package to confuse and overwhelm an enemy's air defense system, causing them to activate their radars and waste their precious SAMs on the decoys while the real strike aircraft follow safely behind. Thanks for watching. Which missile category do you think will shape future warfare the most, and why? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Please also remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.